Did you know that there is actually a creative and useful way you can utilize ChatGPT to generate CSS for you? Stick to the end of this video and you'll get a little bit of insight into how and when ChatGPT can be useful to create CSS. And of course, along the way, you'll also learn about styling tables, converting Chrome extensions to Safari extensions, and styling range sliders. This episode is sponsored by Hypermode. More on Hypermode in a bit. First up, we have Tamania Fifth showing how to create a custom range slider. And this one is truly stunning. If we try it out right here, you're gonna see that not only is this value being updated, which is done purely with CSS, there's no JavaScript whatsoever in this demo. Not only are the values of this range slider updated live as we're moving it, but the effect is really stunning. We have this bouncy, wobbly effect that looks really incredible, and it's hard to imagine that this was created only with CSS. Tamania used anchor positioning and add property extensively to achieve all of that. If you want to learn more, and I strongly suggest you do, then check out this article, dig into it, and you really won't be sorry. Next, we have Michelle Barker and her take on styling tables using modern CSS. Tables, as you probably know if you ever use them, can be quite challenging to get exactly right, especially in the responsive side of things when you need to fit a large amount of data into a really small space, into a really small screen. You'll find quite a bit of modern CSS in this article, like logical CSS properties or where pseudo-class, so on. Of course, a major concern with styling tables is accessibility, and of this article, you'll also see this addressed as well. So if you want to improve your CSS table styling, this is the article to check out by Michelle Barker. This week's sponsor is Hypermode. Hypermode will help you easily integrate AI into your application. And this is not just AI for the sake of AI, like many apps do, unfortunately, these days. But Hypermode will actually improve your application by providing real-time search, recommendations, automations, and more. Hypermode was created by the team that was working on Versal, VS Code, Sentry, and more of those amazing tools, so you can be certain that they stand for quality. If you want to integrate AI in a smart way, effortlessly into your application, then you should try out Hypermode. Click the link in the description, try it out, and you definitely won't be sorry. Thanks so much to Hypermode for sponsoring. Next, we have Nina Torgunakova explaining how to convert Chrome extensions into Safari extensions. If you wonder why you should do that, well, Safari covers almost 20% of the browser market, so it's definitely not something to ignore or overlook. To convert a Chrome extension to Safari one, as Nina explains, you will use Xcode and its Safari Web Extension Converter, which will automatically do most of the process for you, and Nina will tell you everything else that you need to know, for example, incompatibility between some of the APIs that exist in Chrome but not in Safari that you should be aware of. If you ever created a Chrome extension, or if you ever want to create a Chrome extension, then this is the article that will help you effortlessly convert it to extension for Safari. Next, we have Matt Stowman showing how to create a solar system in CSS. The thing that I really like about this article and about Matt's approach is that he extensively uses ChatGPT to generate parts of code that might be daunting to create, like gradients for planets, like sizing of the planets to make them all in perspective, and the animation timings for planet orbits. This is a fascinating demo and a really nice article that shows you that you can actually creatively and effectively use ChatGPT to generate CSS. Of course, you cannot just ask ChatGPT to create an extensive solar system using pure CSS, but for the components that are a little bit more complicated to create, that might need a little bit of mathematics or background knowledge, or are just very extensive in terms of time that you need to actually set up everything perfectly, you can ask ChatGPT to do that for you, and you'll actually get pretty good results, as witnessed in this excellent article by Matt Stowman. Lastly, we have Jason Langsdorff showing a creative way to utilize has pseudo-class. Jason used has pseudo-class to create purely CSS-based filtering system where only items in the list are shown if their respective checkbox is checked. If you dig into the code, you will see that you can very easily achieve that if you use has pseudo-class and just target the appropriate data attributes to hide or show certain items. And this week's question for you is, have you ever used ChatGPT to generate some CSS? And if not, will you ever consider this? Let me know in the comments. Thanks so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different CSS planetary system. Or rather, in the next video. And hopefully without this horrible cold that I'm dealing with that makes my voice really raspy and really bad. Thanks so much. Bye.